All right, so today I want to show you the sizes of ball pythons, all the way from hatchlings all the way up to adults. And I have pretty much every size imaginable. I'm right in the middle of the breeding season, and I have some holdbacks from last year and a bunch of stuff that I bought as grow outs and some fully mature adults, probably all the way from hatchlings all the way up to my biggest ball python is probably about close to 5,000 grams. She is a really big snake. And the funny thing is if you look at ball pythons, you really don't know the size and the age of the ball python. As a matter of fact, some people will show me their ball python and they'll say, well, how old do you think this ball python is? And I would say you really can't tell from just the size of the ball python. It really depends on how much you feed the snake. So if you really feed them a lot, they grow a lot faster, a lot quicker. And if you underfeed them, and in most cases they still look like they're really healthy, but they can stay pretty small. Then I have some ball pythons that I actually bought as grow outs, and they're actually really finicky feeders. And I don't know what Bobby's doing here. He just loves to get up on my head. And as a matter of fact, if I showed you Bobby and said, hey, how old do you think this ball python is? Well, obviously, this one has some age on it because it's pretty big. But if you take a small ball python and you don't really know what the age is, let me tell you, it can trick you into thinking that, I don't know, this snake is crazy today. Whew, I don't know what he's doing today. Anyway, I want to go through and just start pulling some tubs, and I want to show you from the smallest ball python all the way to my biggest ball python, and maybe compare some different ages and different sizes so you can see side by side how some grew a lot faster and they're a lot bigger of the pretty much the same age. So let's jump right into it.
So take a look at this. This is where it all starts. You can't get a snake any smaller than this. This is a brand new hatchling, and essentially I'd say this is pretty much a normal size egg. And right before they hatch, they kind of just stick their head out. That is pretty much the smallest ball python that you can get right out of the egg. And as a matter of fact, right after this, I'm going to do a cutting video on these. These are pretty awesome. I just thought I'd show you. I actually peeked in the incubator and I had one sticking his head out, and that is the smallest snake that you can actually get.
All right, so I wanted to show you a couple hatchlings that I just hatched out. This one was actually a runt of a litter. This is just a regular normal. Her name is Sweetie. She's had two meals so far. And the funny thing is this ball python here is probably as small as a hatchling that would just hatch out of the egg, even after eating two meals. And the funny thing is the hatchlings really hatch out at different sizes. So this one has actually had three meals. This one has had two meals, and you can see how big of a difference in size there is between the two. There's quite a bit of difference. You can tell this one, this is Chewy, my super blast 100% desert ghost. This one's a little bit hissy and kind of looking like it's going to snap at me. Usually once you start getting them on some meals, they get a little bit snippy when they're young. This is a really beautiful snake. But anyway, this is, you know, if you're looking at hatchlings at the shows, a lot of times people sell them this small. I don't really like to sell at the shows this small because, you know, even if they've had two or three meals like this, they're still quite a challenge to eat. As a matter of fact, I just noticed on this one, he's got some really cool, I thought it was a little dirt right behind his eyes. I don't know if you can see that. It's funny, he's got those little black spots right behind his eyes. I never really noticed that when we hatched him out. He's only been out of the egg for, you know, just a few weeks and is eating a few meals. But a lot of people will say they'll feed their ball pythons, you know, three meals and then they'll sell them. And I don't really think a ball python at this stage is really big enough to, you know, eat the frozen thawed. I think it still needs to be on live for quite a few meals. And I typically feed live mice. That's pretty much the only thing these guys will eat until they get, you know, six or seven meals into them. All right, so here's pretty much the next size up. This one is actually eaten, I'd say probably, well, I actually write six plus meals on the tub. It's probably had eight or nine. Pretty much after six meals, I stopped keeping track of how many meals they've had. And you can see after six meals how much bigger they are. This one would definitely be the size that I would consider selling at a reptile show for beginners, really, because, you know, anything smaller than this is really for advanced keepers only. You don't really want to sell anything smaller than this without, you know, telling people, hey, it might be still on live mice, which a lot of people have problems feeding live. This is actually a male fire, 100% het pied. Came from my fire pied. Look how big and beefy it is. This is one of the, I'd say this is probably the perfect size for getting a ball python. I would say I wouldn't get one any smaller than this. This is probably, you know, for beginners, I would say this is probably the bare minimum of a size, you know, where it will feed really well and you won't really have any problems. This one, I haven't actually tried frozen thawed yet, but I'm thinking it could probably easily transition over to a frozen thawed mouse and then eventually over to frozen thawed rats. But that is kind of like, you know, the hatchlings that I would definitely sell at the reptile shows would be about this size. This is about perfect. All right, so take a look at these two snakes. This is one I actually bought online from another breeder. This is a bamboo Enchi clown. Looks really good, really healthy, no problems at all. He's just came out of quarantine, actually. I just bought him. He's been in quarantine about 5 weeks, and I just pulled him out. And if you kind of look at what size he is and the body condition, you could never really tell if he was underfed or not. But I wanted you to compare that one to a snake that I hatched out last year. And take a look at this. This is a hatchling from last year that I have been feeding here in my collection. And essentially, it all comes down to food. So the difference between this snake and this little tiny snake right here is really the amount of food that you feed your snakes. And I essentially have an unlimited supply of rats. I just have so many rats. I just keep feeding these guys and feeding these guys, and they grow like rockets. Whereas a lot of ball python breeders, I would say, they pretty much limit their feed intake on a lot of their snakes. And a lot of times they do it because it's easier to ship, it saves on costs. And ball pythons, you know, I've actually had ball pythons this small that were a year and a half old that I bought online. And I was kind of shocked at how small it was after a year and a half. And I'm thinking, you know, ball pythons should be looking like this after a year. It's pretty incredible the difference in the snake. And you can see both these snakes look really healthy and they're pretty much the same age. It's just a difference of feeding one versus the other. One is eating a lot more, the other one is eating a lot less. All right, so I wanted to show you a couple 2 year old snakes. Both of these are 2 years old. This one is a lesser clown, so it has the lesser gene on top of the clown. And you can see these are both about the same size. This is about what you'd expect, I'd say, from a 2 year old. I've actually seen 2 year olds almost the size of hatchlings. So if you really limit feed your snake, you'll get a really small one. These are both eating really well right now. This white one here is actually a lesser pied, so they both have lesser in them. One has the pied, the white one, and then the other one has the clown, and they're both really just starting to take off and run, if I can keep them in the tub here. And I would say this is probably, you know, for me, this is a really good average size for 2 years old. And the funny thing is this is, you know, some people say it takes 3 years to breed ball pythons. I actually had one that was 2 years old, my clown, pretty much the same size. It laid eggs at 2 years old. But the problem is, a lot of times if you breed at 2 years old, then a lot of times right after they lay eggs, they can actually go off of food. I actually have my pastel spider desert ghost female. She didn't actually lay any eggs, and then she pretty much went on a really long fast. So what you really don't want to do is try to breed these guys and then have them go on a really long fast at this age, because then it takes you forever to get them back up to breeding size. Really, I would recommend doing 3 years, you know, getting a 3 year old snake and, you know, starting breeding at 3 to 5 years probably is what I would recommend. If you breed them too early, you might still get eggs, but a lot of times they'll go on a fast and then it can set you back. So here's a couple 3 year olds. I would say for 3 years old, these are both kind of my smaller, I would say for 3 years old, these guys are pretty small. And the reason is this one right here is a pastel spider desert ghost. Just look at how beautiful this one is. And I actually tried to pair it up at 2 years old, And then she didn't actually breed. She was pretty much like this, only really thick and plump. She was eating really good. I paired her up and they kept locking and locking. And I thought, you know, for sure she's gonna lay eggs, and then she didn't. And then the problem is right after that, she essentially went on a fast and really hasn't eaten hardly anything for the last, probably the last year since I paired her up. So she's pretty much the size of a two-year-old. And I really kind of regret pairing her up. I was like, man, I should have waited one more year, because she was eating like crazy. And if she would have eaten for really heavy for one more year, she would have got a lot bigger and fatter. And then she probably would have had a better chance of continually laying eggs every year. So essentially when you breed them, what happens is you get to the point where you're breeding them and then they go on a fast for like 6 months, and then just a few short months before you breed them again, you're trying to give them a lot of food and bring the weight back up. And it's kind of hard trying to put the size on the snake and breed them at the same time. And then the other one here, this is my pinstripe pied. She's 3 years old, and the problem with her is she just refuses to eat anything. She's just crazy, and pretty much the only thing she'll eat is a live rat only once in a while. And I don't really like doing live rats because, you know, you risk injuring the snake, which I don't really like. So these are kind of, I would say, 3 years old that are both pretty much still at a two-year-old size. All right, so here's a couple of my biggest ball pythons. These are both 6 years old. And of course, you know, Bobby here, the escape artist trying to get out of the tub. And then this other one is a female, 100% het caramel albino. And I actually bred these guys this year and got some eggs. She laid a clutch of like 13 eggs and they hatched, and I already sold the babies. They were, the half of them were bamboos, 50% het caramel albino. So if you're wondering what pretty much the biggest ball python that you can find looks like, I'd say you'd be hard pressed to find anything bigger than snakes like this. All right, so there you have it. That is ball pythons from the smallest hatchling all the way to the adult sizes. And the interesting thing is I actually saw a YouTube video where they took two hatchlings, fed one multiple small rodents versus another hatchling feeding them just one bigger rodent. And the one that was fed bigger rodents actually grew twice as fast is the one with the smaller rodents, which is pretty interesting. So if you're looking for maximum growth, the speed at which they can grow, I would recommend feeding larger rodents. But the interesting thing is if you feed too big of a rodent, essentially what will happen is, for example, if you fed Bobby a rodent that was too big for him, he would actually probably, you know, look like he wants to take the rodent and then just refuse it. That's probably the biggest reason why a lot of ball pythons won't eat that rodent, because it's too big. Or if they do take the rodent, you run the risk of them actually regurgitating, and you definitely don't want to run into that problem, because that could be really hard on the snake. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.